Here in New York City, construction, fences, and scaffolding, well, it's everywhere. But here at the Red Hook Houses, they're converting them into canvases to start conversations about their community.
The Red Hook Houses is in the midst of a $500 million capital transformation post-Hurricane Sandy. Alden Parkinson grew up here. He's back, and so is his art in a big way.
I remember when his brother grew up out here. I love these pictures. You did a good job, my brother.
Parkinson saw an opportunity to turn these construction fences into a backdrop to showcase the lives of his neighbors. Dozens of his photos are now almost 6 feet high, displayed along Columbia Street for blocks.
There's a lot of construction going on, and it just looked terrible. Like, I think art really, like, brightens this neighborhood up, so this is really good that it's my art.
It's all thanks to a new initiative organized by NYCHA, the Department of Cultural Affairs, and a nonprofit organization called ArtBridge. It connects local artists like Parkinson to help transform scaffolding and fencing across the city.
It's beautiful.
Much better. It looks way better.
You do nice work.
A gifted photographer and youth mentor, over the past 8 months, Parkinson took dozens of photos of his favorite people and places in his neighborhood.
This is the G train. I took this last year.
This is the senior center.
I love going there. I didn't realize they were actually going to tear the park down, so it now means more than when I took it, you know?
Karen Blondel is a Red Hook community activist featured in one of his portraits.
When this work went up, it really lifted the spirits of many people in this community, including the construction workers.
Parkinson is one of dozens of local artists who will be showcasing their work at different NYCHA developments across New York City, starting next month. He hopes people walking by stop and take some time to learn more about the neighborhood he loves.
There's a lot of talent out here. There's a lot of people that cares about this neighborhood.
And the next art installations will be at the Jacob Riis Houses on the Lower East Side and the Elliott Chelsea Houses in Chelsea, starting in October. Then after that, at the Mitchell Houses in the South Bronx this winter.